This video is for the multiple choice questions. So let's start with number one. As I explained in the class, this question is asking for the ratio of number of atoms in argon divided by the ratio of number of atoms in the helium. So that's a division sign. So we're looking for the number of moles of argon. So like I explained in the class, when you see this notation, argon 40, that means 1 mole of argon is given to have 40 grams. And then the question gives you 40 grams of it. So obviously 40 gram is, this is 1 mole. That's how much argon we have. And we have 8 grams of helium-4. So this is saying 1 mole is 4 grams, which means when we have 8 grams for each, this means, sorry, there's some lag. This means there's 2 moles of this. So the ratio is obviously 1/2. The second question, which of the following is the temperature of an object related to? So this answer is B. You can't say A because you can't say temperature is energy, and these don't make sense anyway. So actually, some people said, could it be D? This is defining internal energy, just so you know. The sum of kinetic and potential energies in the particles is defining internal energy. Questions asking temperature, so this word is important. Now, we talked about the mole just now. So we have the molar mass of magnesium is 24. So this is the same thing as giving magnesium 24. 1 mole of magnesium is 24. Well, if 1 mole is 24 grams, 12 grams would be half a mole. So this is how much we have in our sample of magnesium that we are given. And the question is saying which one of the below has the same number of particles. So we have half a mole of magnesium. Which one of these is half a mole? So we're looking for the ratio 1/2 of mass to molar mass, which you find in A. So 6 grams of carbon 12, 6 divided by 12 is half, which is the correct answer. This would be 1 mole, 12 gram of carbon 12. 24 gram of carbon 12 would be 2 moles. This is there just for a variety of answers. This is Avogadro's number, but then it says gram, so it's a meaningless choice. Again, similar case, what's the mass of carbon 12 that contains the same number of atoms in 14 gram of silicon 28? So if we have silicon 28, we know 1 mole is 28 grams. If I have 14 grams, that again is half a mole. And the mass of carbon 12 that contains the same number, half a mole of carbon 12, if 1 mole is 12, half a mole will have 6 grams. Number 5, real gases approximate to ideal gases when they are most free, when they can behave the most free scenario. So under low pressure and when they have low density, because this is when they make the least amount of collisions. So they lose less energy and they can behave as an ideal gas. So the answer is D. We solved number 6 in class, but I will present this solution alternatively to people that I solved it another way. Now, we have 2 cases. This is a strategy that works for a lot of multiple choice questions. They give you a case, fixed volume V, N molecules, ideal gas, temperature T, and the pressure is given. And then they change the story. They change some parameters and then look for one of the values in that equation. So first you have to decide what context is this. This is obviously a PVNRT situation because we're relating pressure, volume, NRT. And then You look at what I can write for each case. In this example, fixed volume. So let's write an expression with this for volume. So rearranging this, moving P to the other side, a volume would be nRT over P. And we know this is a constant. So whatever happens to these numbers, the ratio is going to stay the constant because volume is the same no matter what is happening in the story. So if this is the first case, we can now replace the number 20 for the pressure in the first case because that's given. And then the same volume is going to be equal to the ratio with the new numbers. If I'm removing n over 4 molecules, if I'm removing a quarter, I am left with 3/4 of that number I started with. So this is my new n. R is the ideal gas constant, is a constant, and we are told that the new temperature is 2T. And then you solve for what is unknown. Well, P is going to be here because I'm using the pattern for volume, which is nRT over P. So new N, R, new T, and the P is the unknown. So when I cancel everything that is constant on both sides, I get rid of N, R, and T. When you simplify this, this becomes, you can simplify the 2 and the 4. So this is a 2. Well, basically, if you rearrange, you can cross multiply. You can even simplify 2 and the 10. So when you cross multiply, P becomes 3 times 10, which is a 30. I also showed an alternative method for this. Like I can include it in this video because some people might find this more friendly and some people like the other way, which is perfectly fine. I'm going to use the same formula, PV and RT, but I will just write the numbers that I know in it. So I know P is 20 and V is V, N is N, R is R, and T is T. For the second case, I don't know P. I know V is still the same V. I know we are left with 3N over 4. And then R is R. It's a constant. And T becomes 2T. Now, I'm obviously doing mathematically the same thing, but this might look more friendly to some of you than that one. Up to you. Then I cancel the same ones on the two formulas, cancel the same parameters. And then there's some ratio here, like some module that is equivalent to 20. nRT is going to be equal to 20. I canceled everything that is the same. Let's say this is an X, some value equals to 20. I can simplify the 2 and the 4. So the same module here, 3 times 2, if one module is 20, 3/2 of that module is going to be 30. Mathematically, they reach the same conclusion, but like I said, whichever way looks more friendly to you, that's totally fine. Yes, in a multiple choice, you don't have to show your work, but what if you have to? Okay, number 7, fixed mass of an ideal gas. So we have the same number of moles in the question. Trapped in a cylinder of constant volume, and its temperature is varied. Please remember, at constant volume, pressure is directly proportional to temperature, which means it's obviously not going to be B or D. And a lot of you were confused between A and C. It has to be A because these axes are given in Celsius. And when in Celsius, you cannot have a zero intercept. To have a zero intercept, this graph has to be in Kelvin because zero Kelvin is absolute zero, where we would assume pressure to be zero. And if you extrapolate this, you will see that it will have a negative temperature intercept. This is absolute zero at negative Celsius. So because of the unit, it has to be A. What does N represent in the equation of the ideal gas law? Well, I hope you know that by now. It's the number of moles of the gas. Not the number of molecules, not the number of atoms, not the number of particles, none of that, number of moles. So how many mole groups are there in the gas? That's that number. Number nine, we have another ratio question, a case one and a case two. Let's do the same thing we did before. Let's use PV and RT. I'll just directly put the numbers in. So case one, we have 100 kilopascal. V is 15. N is N. R is R. Constants. And temperature is 20. I cannot put 20 here because it's really important that you have to change these temperatures to Kelvin when you use PV and RT. The instant you use 20 here, you get the wrong answer, and the wrong answer is there. So case number two, we're looking for the new pressure, so just put that as P. We know the new volume is a 5. N is N, R is R, and the new temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. I have to convert that to Celsius, which would be add 273. You get that. Cancel the common ones. Simplify where you can. And you can even see this side as 300. So then, remember, in a multiple choice exam, a paper one, full paper one, will not allow you to use a calculator. So in case you didn't know this, in an actual paper one, which is multiple choice alone, you are not allowed to use calculators in physics. So you might be thinking, like, how on earth am I supposed to calculate this? You're not going to calculate this. You're going to estimate, choose the bestest answer. This the most reasonable answer. So temperature is increasing, so pressure must increase. So obviously, I'm going to cancel 35. It's not going to get less. From 300, again, I will cancel 200 because from 300, I need to increase. I can't use this one. 600 is twice 300. The temperature is not becoming twice, so this is not going to increase by two times. The only reasonable answer is 320. So you estimate. Okay, another trouble question. We are now again using PV and RT, and the graph gradient is the question. Now we have learned, and I know you've learned this really well. I'm really proud of you that you're all able to reason this out. When a graph asks you about the gradient, you know we are looking for the ratio of y component to the x component. So this is what the question is asking you. We need an expression which is equivalent to that. So let's rearrange our PV and RT formula to see what is V over T equal to. So I want to find V over T. So let's move T here and let's move the P here. And that gives V over T equals NR over P. This is a moment where a lot of you, including me in the class when I was rushing, thought that we got the answer. And you say, B, yes, I got it. No, that's wrong. And you know why? The question gives you the number of molecules. But remember, what was N? We answered that question. N is the number of moles, not the number of molecules. So we cannot use N as number of molecules in this. So what are we going to do? For N, let's keep going. I am going to include what I would do for calculating number of moles, which is the number of molecules divided by Avogadro's number. And then, the equation becomes, let's keep the R here and the P is here. So all I did was for N, for this, I wrote this. Okay, everything else is the same. And then I still can't find it in the choices, but there is something about KB. What is KB? It's the Boltzmann constant. Now you have this in the data booklet in 3.2. Boltzmann constant is R ratio to Avogadro's number ratio. So what I can now do is for, oh, sorry, the highlighter. I wanted to highlight in a different color. This R over NA ratio is the Boltzmann constant. So I'm going to rewrite that section as, see, I have the N, that is the number of molecules. I have the P downstairs in here, and I'm going to use KB to represent that R over NA ratio. So that's why the answer is C. Be very careful with the wording in every question. Okay, in the kinetic model of the ideal gas, which one is not assumed? To know the answer to this, you basically have to memorize what are the assumptions of the ideal gases. B. We don't assume that the energy of a given molecule is constant. They collide, they change direction and velocity and kinetic energy, yes, but the average is what we look for anyway, so we don't assume that. 12 is asking for the definition of the mole. This definition relates to the number of particles, atoms in 12 grams of carbon 12. B or D seem to be saying the same thing, but answer is D because the amount of substance that contains as many elementary entities as the number of atoms in 12 gram of carbon 12, not nuclei, number of atoms, and the amount of substance doesn't necessarily relate to the number of nuclei in a mole of anything. It's just a count of any elementary entity. So better answer is D. This is actually the same question. I'll jump to 15 here. This is the same question. So the answer would be, is an assumption of the kinetic model of an ideal gas. The only reasonable option is C, collisions between particles are elastic. And this, A, only because we know pressure. This is a direct proportionality line, a straight line going from the origin. So this gives pressure is directly proportional to T. That is possible only when volume is constant. Well, it's a constant amount of gas. We're not adding or taking away the number, fixed mass. See, mass is constant, volume is constant, density is naturally constant. That's why answer is A.